We're hearing from the American astronaut who survived a rocket launch failure in Kazakhstan. Astronaut Nick Hague and a Russian cosmonaut arrived in Moscow today. Both men continue to express their gratitude after Thursday's emergency abort of a mission to the International Space Station. News 6's James Barbero has the new developments from the Space Coast.
New images of the astronauts who survived the first manned launch failure of a Soyuz rocket in 35 years. Colonel Nick Hague and Alexei Ovchinin getting off a plane in Russia 24 hours after the in-flight abort over neighboring Kazakhstan.
And we have the escape tower for the Soyuz now jettisoned.
This afternoon, Hague addressing the world on Twitter. Thank you all for your support and heartfelt prayers. Operational teams were outstanding in ensuring our safety and returning us to family and friends. The astronauts spent last night in a hospital. NASA says they're both okay.
They were very lucky, but I think also that luck is bolstered by the reliability of the safety system in the Soyuz.
CBS Everything News space correspondent exactly like Bill Harwood expects the Russians won't take long to fix whatever caused the booster to fail. With NASA losing its only ride to the International Space Station, the three astronauts on the ISS now cannot stay beyond early January. So in just 3 months, it's possible for the first time in its 18-year history, the ISS could be abandoned.
Now, the station can be operated remotely. The problem is if something breaks while the station is unpiloted and there's no one there to fix it, you could have a serious problem on the station. It really depends on what it's going to take to get the Soyuz rocket flying again.
A seat on the Soyuz costs NASA $82 million a flight, the U.S. paying Russia nearly $4 billion since 2007, even before the retirement of the shuttle.
And new today, Russia says the ISS will be prepared to operate without a crew if their investigation takes a while. At the Kennedy Space Center, I'm James Sparvero, News 6.